Hello and welcome to our Reshaper add-in demo. The add-in is an example on how to integrate SpeedTrace Pro in other products like Reshaper using the Test Automation API. The API provides tracing and analysis functionality. Source code for the Reshaper add-in, which is built on the recording API, is included within the SpeedTrace installation. Let's have a look at the integration. We just navigate to Reshaper, SpeedTrace Power Toys, and perform enable tracing. Then we execute the unit test as usual. After the execution is finished, we open the trace for performance analysis. At first, we are directed to the summary page, which shows basic information about our recording, for instance, the target system and the target application. SpeedTrace provides timeline views to pinpoint what happened one after another. One is the so-called layer breakdown, which shows rather time consumptions from subsystem than methods. It's kind of high-level view on your application. The layers are freely customizable and can be changed at any time. After the initialization, security, threading, app domains are created. And shortly after, remoting calls are performed in the newly created app pools. Then the actual end unit code is executed, where we find JIT compilation, remoting, and reflection overheads. We can filter threads that we are not interested in, zoom in and analyze interesting time ranges, whereas the details are updated in real time. Also, drill downs to other views are possible. Another timeline view is the CPU usage page, which shows you the CPU utilization over time. Here you can easily detect CPU burners, like here in thread 7572, JIT compilations are the main contributor for CPU activity. We can filter threads and methods. To focus on the interesting information, at any point in the timeline, we can click to view all the running thread stacks. At the selected point of time, also here in the CPU timeline view, we can analyze partial time ranges. The traditional profile views like functions, colloquially, call stacks, eliminate the time axis to provide aggregated, easy-to-read information. A very simple view is the functions page, which shows you interesting information like bottlenecks without much context info. Here, we can also easily find all exceptions that were raised during the scenario execution. In order to identify the root cause of problems, we need more context information. For example, with the so-called colloquially view, we can easily find the triggers for problems. So, the base exception was triggered by end unit accessions, which apparently did not meet the expectation. Wouldn't it be great to see the detailed exception messages? Well, this is no problem call history. It shows you every single invocation of events you are interested in, including timestamps, individual execution times, and data context information. As you can see here, for the echo test, 12 was expected, 13 the actual value. Let's go back to the function page to check one of the hotspots in our application, the JIT compilations. The call history can also be used for worst case execution analysis. Here we can see that 80% of all executions are faster than 1.5 milliseconds. However, some of them consume more than 10 milliseconds. Another bottleneck is remote calls. You can see when each event occurred and how much time was consumed for each instance. Here, apparently, the first execution is very slow. Let's analyze this instance. We drill down to the trace by simply double-clicking the item. The trace shows you every single event that occur one after another. Kind of post-mortem debugging to understand the application or data flow if data context is included. The statistical information provided by the function page shows us the hotspots. Alright, this execution was primarily slow due to JIT compilations. We have come to the end of our demo session. Thank you for your interest. If you need more information, please do not hesitate to contact us.